Throughout this course, we follow the case of Brian, who is a 29-year-old male who presented to me after a blackout. Brian's problems appear to have started a year ago when he was involved in a serious motor vehicle accident. To understand what happened to Brian, we're going to go back a year and hear from a junior doctor in the accident and emergency department.
Well, in Bay 4, we have got 26-year-old male Brian. He was brought in by an ambulance about an hour ago. Witnesses reported that they saw Brian's car run a red light and he did get hit on the right-hand side. By the time the ambulance guys arrived, the other motorists had already pulled him out of the car. The ambulance guys did say that he was wearing a seatbelt, so that's good. When we examined him on the emergency department a short time ago, we could see some early signs of bruising on his right thigh and, of course, bruising and swelling over his right shoulder and upper arm and, of course, over his chest just related to the seatbelt. He's in quite a bit of pain, mainly just in his right arm, which is sore to touch. His blood pressure is pretty good, about 150 over 90. Exam is normal apart from his arm, just abdomen is soft and his lungs and his heart check out fine. No signs on neurological examination. So we're just going to give him some painkillers and we are sending him off for an X-ray of his arm and his chest. So I think it will turn out that we are dealing with a fracture of the arm, but not to be concerned about any internal injuries at this stage. So you can see here, he does have an obvious fracture in the upper part of the large bone in his arm called the humerus. I dare say we'll send him to the orthopaedic ward for surgery and we will have to get a plate in that bone just later today. And all going well, I think we'll be able to send him home in a couple of days.